Alrighty. Back again. Ooh, really getting down on the home stretch here. Kind of a tricky situation. Alright, a couple things we need to add before we start shading in all this stuff. Got this little thing right there. Couple of things. I'm not gonna screw around with that stuff too much. We've pretty much put down everything I feel like putting down. Alright, let's vacuum actually a fair amount of this stuff. That before, but whatever. Okay, look, so we've got a lot of grid lines we got to get rid of. Let's do that. Let's vacuum that. Okay, look, let's start with, let's take some of this brownish stuff here and just kind of, I think I see this is right here, was kind of alright, let's take some of the light green and just get going. Enough stalling. So kind of along here. And we're gonna obviously switch this over to slightly darker, but let's just kind of start with something. You just gotta start with something. Let's get some Yellow. Some of this yellow in here. Now, kind of down here, it becomes just more yellow. Kind of in here. Now, there's really what we're going to need to do is kind of shift the color of this green to something grayer. Where's our light gray? Yeah, there it is. Now let's try to kind of go over this. Kind of go over this. The gray. Might be easier if we, I think we need to smudge this stuff in and then come back over it with the gray. I mean, this stuff is really supposed to be really out of focus and not well delineated at all. But, okay, so let's do that. Let's put, actually, let's, is it a different color? Let's see what happens if we put a bunch of this sort of light colored chalk on top of all this. Let's just try this. Let's kind of just rub that into the background a little bit. Let's get a little more. Let's get our light gray kind of going on top of this stuff just a bit. Kind of real, just kind of soft, and kind of use this to kind of I'm gonna put it down pretty hard, but it still needs to be really fluffy. Got these sort of things shooting off to the sides. We just kind of do that a lot with shading, I think. Let's put this over here. Vacuum that. Alright, let's get our gray and kind of just make these things. I'm not sure where this. So right there, that should really look more this color. No, not that color. Or is that one? Maybe more like this, to be honest. More like that, yeah. But these things are all just kind of... Let's take the gray chalk and just kind of give these things a little more sort of irregular edges. Let's just kind of smudge those in just a bit. But we're kind of sort of getting ahead of ourselves a little bit. Let's kind of, okay, so over here we need a little more of this. Let's take out a few more grid lines over here. Use this as the alright, let's put some more of this light green kind of up against in here. That, and then down there it becomes more yellow again. I think this light peach colored chalk is gonna be good for a lot of this stuff. It's good to just kind of fill in this background when I don't know what the freak else to put. Screwed up over there. All right, let's take the white pencil for a second. If we can find it. There it is. Let's just kind of go. Alright, so over here, kind of got this yellowish. Light greenish. Let's use the gray. Actually, let's use this light brownish junk right here. Put a little bit of that in there. Let's add a little bit of that to these. Not too much. Let's try to take a little bit of this stuff right over here. All right, one thing we need to do, change the batteries again for the 800th time. Alright, let's clean up this border just a bit. We've got these little screw ups in here. That's good. Alright, let's vacuum that. See, this is the problem. Literally, there's some things that are just next to impossible to do from the angle you're doing it from. Or for me, anyway. Alright, before we clean up too much, let's let's just continue. Let's not. Well, actually, let's do this. Yeah, let's. I think we need a little bit of this pale yellow, kind of in here. I'm gonna come over it with a white. Yeah, come over it with the white, kind of. Let's get the white. Where's the white? So we need to kind of have this sort of like. Just needs to look blurry. It doesn't need to look. I mean, some of this you can never replicate. Those little bright things, kind of. Not on the first pass, anyway. It might have to be when you. After you fix the picture. Alright, that's okay. Alright, now let's just go. And add some of this. Let's get these some of these grid lines out of our way over here. Well, this one don't do no. Let's vacuum all that. So over here, I think we need to put some of this light yellowish whatever. Let's just kind of shade that in. I really feel like if anything, the mistake we've made in some of these, we've kind of just underdone. We've made some areas markedly too dark. And other areas not dark enough, which I guess is kind of. So let's kind of come around here, just go over these things, and you can notice kind of on top it becomes kind of on top of that, we're gonna put a little more yellow. Let's throw in this. Let's just kind of accentuate the edges of these little raindrops. Let's erase. Kind of clear the edges a little bit. Let's vacuum all that. All right, let's just keep filling in this stuff. This sort of light color. I mean, really, almost all of it. But that is one thing you have to be careful. When you are rubbing in something light next to something very dark, carryover is absolutely gonna haunt you. All right, let's, before we go too far, let's just add some yellow, some real yellow, kind of in here. Fuck. It's kind of just this yellow in here. Kind of over here. And then a little coming in here. All clean up some of these. The problem we're gonna run into is these big areas, you can't fill them in with just, you can't just totally skip out on the details, or it's gonna just look two-dimensional. So we're gonna have to be a little more attentive. So first thing, let's throw in just a little bit of our light gray, kind of on top of, kind of just in here. We don't want this to look just so flat and all the same exact. You know, you gotta give it some texture. Kind of make this just a little bit, give it some character. All up in here. And that might be really all it takes. You know, you just can't have it. What do we need to put between these things? I'm gonna put, let's put some more of this. That stuff. Now let's put some real yellow. Kind of like a bunch of yellow in here. And let's take some of this sort of browner thing, kind of put some of that in here. I think we need some of that kind of like, kind of going in here, making it just a little bit more, not quite as well defined. Patching it around, not too much of it, just a bit. And we need to bring this edge closer to the edge. Alright, we need, let's take this one, and we just need to kind of put a little bit more. This thing just kind of comes over here and sort of changes to like this shade over here. And let's put some gray on top of all this kind of. And it is definitely not supposed to be that well visualized, but we can work on that. Alright, now, I think something worth Well, let's just finish it out. Let's just finish. I think I know what we want to do. And I think I know where we're going to stop before we sort of go too far. Let's, take these grid lines out. Just take this gray, kind of take this thing just a little bit, really nondescript. Let's add this one we've been adding in between all this. This thing actually needs a little bit of this green kind of hanging around. Actually, some of this. All right, let's take our gray. Let's accentuate these things one more time. Just give them a little bit of nondescript character. It's kind of just just kind of just making up stuff. I mean, at this point, it doesn't really matter. Let's vacuum that. Now, over here, let's kind of, I mean, do something I guess we didn't really kind of do yet, which we need to do, is kind of give all this some character with this. Thank you. Let's add some of that yellow back to here. Some of that yellow. And here. Alright, now we're gonna make some attempt. Well, let's. God. Alright, let's do this. Then we'll come back and try to lighten up the areas that need to be wider. All right, and there's definitely some little kind of details we need to throw in here a little bit. This sort of... Let's just put in this base, this light thing we've been putting in. Put that in there. God, I'm telling you, avoid the green. It will destroy everything. And it's a fact. Look at that shit. All right, let's put some, let's put some of this. All put some gray. Take a light gray. I really wish we had different, let's see. Put just a smudge of gray on just top of all this, very nondescript, very minimal. Let's start. Before we go any further, we're just gonna try to do what we've done so far and complete it. So first thing we need to realize, these things are like kind of raindrops. Let me sharpen the white because we're gonna need that. We need the eraser, and we are going to put in just a line of light. Pale areas, just kind of all over the place. And they will shine through to some extent. Because once you erase, it tends to stick somehow. Even though we don't want it to shine through completely. But there are some important ones over here. vacuum. Let's take that pale yellow. Sharpen it. What? Vacuum that. Alright, so now we are going to take a lot of white chalk. Actually, let's do something first. Let's do this. Usually I do this last, but I don't know why I feel like doing it now. Alright, now let's make the... Vacuum. Alright, now let's get the white chalk. We have a lot to do. We are gonna splotch on quite a bit of this. Let's make sure it's clean-ish. Okay, we got a lot of white going. Kind of just coming up between these things. And then between here, vacuum that. gotta put a lot of white in here. And it doesn't have to be uniform. What have we failed to do that we need to do? I think over here we need to put a little more gray, just kind of just around these areas. Where's the light gray? Just gonna put we just need a little more splotchiness just kind of over here. We don't want it to look so uniform because then it just looks stupid. It might look stupid anyway, I don't know. But I do wonder if this, all these little microscopic white flecks that are very difficult to demonstrate. Actually, let's use this one. Let's use this. Kind of put that in there. Put that on there just a bit. That ain't doing right. Shit. Keep screwing up over here because this area needs to look white. really need to leave that area alone. Let's try and deal with this border now. Let's vacuum that. Let's take the gray. Just make a little bit more splotchy in here. Just a little bit. That's definitely tricky. I mean, this, I'm telling you, this flower has been a freaking challenge. But I think we've done an okay job so far. But I'm not sure. Definitely need more stuff. Jeez, not that much, for God's sakes. I wonder how ridiculous it would be to try and put a bunch of bright white things. Might actually be worth the trouble. Probably more worth it after we fix the picture. Just can't help but feel like we need to try now. I don't know why. Ain't no way any of that did anything. All right, let's, I think I did okay today. I don't know, it's actually not too bad. We'll see. All right, next time.